Hi everyone! Today I want to do the level 58 White Mage quest. We are here in the Trovanian Forelands, a Tailfeather X32.35 33.1 Z 1.0. We have to talk to a Shiva, but before I do this, I will show you the gear I've bought in Ishgard at the Merchants and the Market Board. It's the normal quality gear for level 58. Normally you should have better gear. So, okay. Let's talk to a Shiva. Quest is in the Wake of Death, and we get a new command, Arrow 3. Deals with wind damage with the potency of 50 to target and all enemies nearby it. Additional effect, wind damage over time, potency 40, duration 24 seconds, cast time 2.43 seconds, recast 2.43 seconds, MP 530, range 25 yards, radius 5 yards. Shiva is eager to share new information on Alacqua. Good tidings, sweet. I have acquired definite information on Alacqua. As before, the stench of death gave her away. A hunter she chanced to walk near couldn't help but notice to smell. When she realized that she was being observed, she quickly turned her steps west towards dragon territory. The hunter shouted a warning, but she continued on heedless. In light of her inclinations, I dare say she has business there. There is an area called Avalonia Fallen to the west. Let us head in that direction and try to pick up Alacqua's trail. I will take my chocobo with me. No signs of Alacqua, and the area beyond is fraught with danger. Not even hunters dare venture in. I would sooner not wander these parts without some guarantee that Alacqua is near, but we cannot afford to delay lest she elude us completely. Let us split up and search. If you would focus on the area to the north, I shall follow the high road west. Oh, and do keep an eye out for the Taint. If Alacqua is here, it is like to have manifested. A foul taint. Okay. maybe interact with the foul taint. Alakwa is not here. Rejoin Ashiva on the westbound high road. Okay. You should not have startled me. You. I see you are the one who undid my work. Why do you interfere with my experiment? So it was you who created the taint? The taint, you say? An insult born of ignorance. What you so callously destroyed is a wellspring of life-giving ether. What are you saying? The taint is befouled ether. It destroys life. So you choose to cling to your ignorance like all the others, but it matters not what you think. When my experiment is complete, all the fools who tormented me in mine shall get their comeuppance. No, we won't let you continue your twisted experiment. Sweet, stop her. I believe you have more pressing concerns. Drawn to the ether, I shouldn't downed or detained as you insist on calling it, but such details are immaterial. By whatever name it is known, I shall fill the world with it and have my revenge. Do not interfere. Consider this your final warning. With this foul taint. You find a peculiar hunk of flesh on the ground. Thank you, sweet. Again, you have saved me, and again I am reminded of my own weakness. What do you have there? Ah, this is well skipped my last meal. I'd figure this is part of Alacqua's experiment. The CTS may be able to glean something from it, and yet I find myself loath to seek them out. They haven't lifted so much as a finger to left to help us. What can we expect of them now? We should consult them anyway. Now is not the time to be stubborn. We consult them anyway. You have the right of it, sweet. There's more at stake than a difference of opinion. If we are to save the Dwarfswood, we must needs turn to the Sitius for aid. It's settled then, we return to the Dwarfswood. Complete. And we learned the new command. So, and we have another quest for level 58. And we talk to Ashiva, Trials of the Pajars. Ashiva is ready to return to the Dwarfswood to petition the Sitius' aid. Please hold on to the hunk of flesh. It's safer your keeping. Now then, let us return to Camp Tranquil and explain the situation to the Sitius. Okay. So, Camp Tranquil. Ah, you are returned. How fares the effort to purge the taint? You wish to show us something? What does it tell us, brother? The elementals are in trepidation of the flesh. It is infused with befouled ether. Of this there can be no doubt. And with the Great One's warnings growing ever more fervent, it seems plain that this Alacra continues to soar detained. Whatever it is she seeks to do, we must put a stop to it. Arun, I shall take a closer look at the flesh. In the meantime, you must resume your journey of purification. What? With all due respect. Oh, to hell's with respect. I can't believe what I'm hearing. You would send us back into the midst of danger and with nary a word of counsel? I know full well that we ask much of you, but there's none other upon whom we can depend. Depend, you say? Instead of depending upon others, why don't you do something for a change? We all know that you both have the power to do so. Do you realize how much sweat has been thrown in your names? Oh, but of course you don't, because while she bled for you, you were hiding here with your heads in the treetops. If Master Atova were to see this, he would be turning in his grave. Heads in the treetops? What is the matter with her? To think that our own people see us in such a light. I cannot be helped, brother. We are bound to remain in the forest. Things are not as they were during Master Atova's time. But that is... Be that as it may be. Be that as it may, were the people to lose faith in us, for whom shall we convey with the will of the elementals? Forgive me, sweet, but I would be alone. Rest assured, I will take a closer look at the taint flesh. Arun has the right of it. It is our duty to facilitate harmony between man and elemental. All the laws of the forest count for naught if we fail in this. At any rate, we must needs stop Alakwa's dark designs. And fear not, sweet. Henceforth, we will not leave you to bear the burden alone. Pray allow us the time to consider our next step. Okay. Then I say thank you for watching. I will see you the next time. Bye bye.